Good morning to all of you. We were once a great country. Somewhere, something went wrong. A tiny country called Britain came, conquered us. During Industrial Revolution, during that Reformation era, India lost out. All that great things which ancient India did, all got wiped out. We were for 200 years enslaved by a tiny country called Britain. Today, we are at a very interesting inflection point of human history. On the one hand, we as humans are trying to teach machines to think like humans, to speak like humans, to recognize human speech with all its variations, with all its contextual differences, and do most of daily chores by machines so that humans are left with enough time to do better things, to work more creatively. I give you another interesting perspective. The machines which we created are trying to teach us not to be irrational in our behavior, not to be prejudiced in our cognition, not to be colored in our perception, to be more scientific, to be more rational, to respond to any situation in a more objective and non-prejudiced manner. Today, the world is being impacted by these new cutting-edge technologies which never happened in human history. Today, it took about 60 years of independence for India to become a trillion-dollar economy. If you look at some of the companies like Amazon, Google, etc., they themselves have become a trillion-dollar economy companies. In terms of competitiveness internationally, tiny countries which got independence much later than us, say Korea, South Korea. Today, half my products, my trains are imported from Korea. My AFC gates, automatic fare collection gates, I have imported from Korea. Half my products I had to import. Why a country with 130 crore population? You look at South Korea, Samsung, LG, Hyundai, Rotem, anything you name, actually they have produced only 6 crore population. The amount of emphasis, the amount of money they have spent on education is something phenomenal. That's how today those countries are what they are. We are not able to compete with those countries. Forget about the developed West. We're not even able to compete with that. China, imagine the kind of thing, anything, any particular sector you take, China is 10 times, 20 times, 100 times ahead of India. How did it happen? In just a matter of the Chinese culture, the way things happen in China, how they used to sleep in the afternoon, etc., for hours, the machines were completely closed down, etc., we used to make crack jokes. But today, imagine where is China and where we are. If we have to internationally compete, if we have to survive in this globalized era, it's your brain power, your capability, your hard work, your dedication that makes all the difference. As you are participating in a hackathon, I also did some sort of a hackathon to identify the problem of the city. Transportation is an important issue in the city. Then you have to think about a solution. So almost 1 year of research, I did not jump at metro just like that. Okay? I did about 1 year of research, went around the world, checked up different systems, metro rail systems, LRT systems, BRT systems, etc., etc. So I had to decide that at least 50,000 PHPDT, that means in 1 hour from point A to point B in one direction, I require capability of transporting 50,000 people. That's possible only with a rail-based mass transit system, metro rail.
Nazreen, siyasi aur mazhabi khabron ke liye subscribe kare apna YouTube channel.